as long as you hit a nice little pay streak like this, 30, 40 feet deep, it's a pretty nice surprise. You know, gotta be a lot more confident that he's gonna reach his 5,000 ounce goal.
25 feet down in his new favorite glory hole, Tony Beets is racing to stockpile and sluice it all.
We had no idea how much gold was gonna come out of it either. I'll be definitely way up there. So yeah, 5,000 ounces, I think, looking at this material here, will be well within our reach. Look at the wedges, you see that? Another one.
Battling to hit a record 5,000 ounce goal. Disaster has struck the Beets' only moneymaker.
There's one over there.
Another one? Where's the other one?
Right there. There's two down here in the grease, but I ain't touching those.
All season, Tony's relied on chief mechanic, son Kevin, to keep his iron fleet and Trommel running.
So there's all these wedges out. That means this must have been doing this for a little bit.
Hey, Mike, give her a bump so she makes a half a spin. Good. Oh, look at that one, Gavin. See the crack in here?
The Trommel separates gold-rich dirt from rocks using a 40-foot-long barrel, which is rotated by two running rings and held in place by metal wedges. Wear and tear from years of hard sluicing has broken some of the wedges' welds. As they came loose, a monster barrel dropped, cracking one of the crucial running rings.
Well, I don't think we should run it like this.
No, well, lucky that it didn't crack and just came as and then chunk falls off. So I'd say you're pretty much toast.
Why don't we have a look? Maybe we can make it work for a week. We could have a look. Might as well.
Okay, you have a look at that, and yeah, well, it's not good the way it is right now, so let's do it, see what we can do, and let know. All ready? Okay, Mike, pipe layer is yours. Rip the things off.
Yep.
To access the damage, Tony's crew must take the Trommel apart.
Okay, good, let's do it. Okay, Mike, lift her up. Swing the and keep her going.
First, they lift the conveyor out of the way.
Mike down a bit, Mike down a bit.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Okay, hold it, Mike. Perfect. Now let it down, Mike.
Next, the giant 40-ton barrel.
Whoa!
If you want it down the right, you're gonna have to do it yourself.
Now this is a lot of effort to get everything out of here and moved. Hopefully when it's on the ground, we can have a better look. Maybe see if that crack is fixable, but right now let's just focus on getting it out.
The barrel has not been moved for over 10 years.
Is that good for you? Mike, I think you gotta drive ahead of here, man. See if we can lift the slowly.
Thank you.
Mike down, Mike down. Perfect. Good piece of cake, really.
Now it's on the ground, we can have a better look, make a plan.
Yeah, these two are about ready to fall out.
Like 80% of the wedges, all the welds are cracked. This is the one crack that's all the way through the thing. Tony's not gonna be too happy.
What do you got, Gavin?
Cheap.
Well, I knew that.
I know a lot of your wedges are pretty worn. The crack on the ring's all the way through, at least the big one. There's two more that are started about a quarter way.
Okay. I
mean, we definitely can't run like this. This part here is about ready to snap off, and that'll not only the ring lock tight, just tear everything apart.
So, long story short?
If you had four or five welders, throw at it.
Four or five welders would be in each other's way, but how about two of them? One on each side.
I don't think it will get done. We don't have near enough people who can weld our air arc to do all this before end of season.
Anyway, so we're gonna call this quits then?
But I don't think we have enough people and time to make it work in the time frame we have left.
Okay.
That's sucks. Next year project.
After a season fixing every machine on Paradise Hill, Kevin has finally met his match. The beat season is over.
Hey guys,
we're taking over your gold lay.
After 6 months working alongside the family, Ruby and cousin Mike join the Beets for their final gold weigh of the season.
Why are you guys here? What's that?
So Michael,
yeah, why are we here?
Michael, you're second year. Ruby, you're what, seventh year?
My sixth year.
Sixth year?
Yeah. Forever year.
How'd it go?
I can see the grays.
Hey. I think we had a relatively good season. Did we do enough? Good enough job this year to hire us back next year?
I doubt that very much. It's on a year-to-year basis.
You're stuck with, like, your new favorite son, Michael.
Okay.
And your new favorite daughter, Ruby.
Okay, that's fine.
Bye.
Anyway, last gold weigh, guys.
Yay.
Done. Yeah. Over with. Right? Yay. Get the out of here, so to speak. Hi.
Yeah.
Now we're going to go out with a bang or not. We'll have to find out.
Tony gambled his final week on a glory hole, but the trommel died before he could sluice all its pay.
All right, Kevin, you ready?
I'm not counting.
It's his turn to count.
Let Nick count. There you go. Yeah.
No, we've all counted, so it's your turn.
It's your turn to count.
Has Ruby counted yet?
Yeah. This isn't my first gold way.
Ready. 20, 30, 40, 50, 100.
Tony needs 400 ounces to hit a record 5,000-ounce season goal.
To 10, to 20, to 90, 300, 370, 420.
Slow down, Kevin.
Yeah. I can keep up with you, Kevin.
That's doing good already, Minnie.
470, 480, 490, 500, 510, 520. 90, 600, 610, 620, 660.
There's more.
680, 690, 694.02.
Worth $1.2 million.
What? Holy crap.
The glory hole delivered the best gold of the season and brings their final total to 5,295 ounces, smashing their record goal target and banking the Beets' first $9 million season.